Now, I'm going to explain how the regulation of the digestive enzymes and bile occurs when the digestion in duodenum occurs. All the enzymes which come for the digestion in the duodenum, they come from the pancreas. Okay? And but bile is produced in the liver, and that gets into duodenum through the hepatopancreatic duct, which is formed by the combination of what we call bile duct and pancreatic duct. The common bile duct is formed by the combination of cystic duct and hepatic duct. Hepatic duct and cystic duct, they bring what? The bile from either directly from the liver tissue or from gallbladder. In gallbladder, the gall and the bile is stored. Well, how the secretion of bile and pancreatic juice is regulated? We have to discuss all these in this lecture. Well, as the food material enters into duodenum, from the duodenal mucosa, this is what? The duodenal mucosa. Here is what? Duodenal mucosa. From here, secretin is produced. Secretin is a 27 amino acid hormone. Okay? It's a peptide consisting of 27 amino acids. Now, as it is produced from here, it acts on what? The gallbladder to produce, to secrete what? To secrete the bile. And also on what? The tissue of pancreas to secrete what? The pancreatic juice. You see, as the digestion is completed here in the stomach, the gastrin has a key role, it has a vital role upon the regulation of the gastric juice. When that digestion is completed in the stomach, the gastrin has no more room. So the second function of secretin is what? The inhibition of gastrin. So here is what we can say, we can conclude that gastrin has two types of function. One is what? Secretory function, secretion of bile and secretion of pancreatic juice. The second is what? Inhibitory function, that inhibits the production of what? Secretion of what? The gastric juice. Okay? And indirectly, it acts upon the production of gastrin. In the next lecture, we'll start with